Hey everybody, it's Nick and Jay, and before we get into the recap for MSR 2019, we just wanted to let you guys know that American Cities Racing League champion 1997, Jeff Glenn, is no longer going to be day-to-day in the Lemons office. You might see him at a couple of races, but he just didn't want to be in the office anymore.
PC load letter? What does that mean?
I think it's something in the water, man. It's got to be in the water.
Yeah, I don't know what that's about, but taking over his duties is going to be Kim Harmon and Lisa Sims. Now, Lisa, you're going to remember from California events and a lot of Lemons back office operations. And Kim, well, you remember Kim from this.
They keep your feet warm, okay, but there's the problem of your scrotum.
Can't we go kinda, one video without saying kinda. The word scrotum?
Yeah, but that was a long time ago, and frankly, the scrotium thing has really run its course, and we're not going to be doing that anymore, or any testicular humor for that matter.
Yeah.
Mixed nuts?
Nuts! Hot, salty nuts! Who wants them?
Alright, so back to MSR 2019. This, of course, is the Yokohama Stuntin' and Splodin' Soiree, which is sponsored by our friends at Yokohama Tires. And because it's Houston, we did another round of slab penalties. Team Winfinity probably did the best one.
Still tipping on fofos. Ripped in fofos.
But terrible Red Rat Racing struggled all weekend long with their, you know, should have been easy to run E30.
Yeah, but, you know, it's easy-ish, but it's not a real, true, proven classic. You know, like a 2002. Yeah, but speaking of classics, you know those Ford Pintos? They're always bursting into flames.
You know what will totally never burst into flame? Escape Velocity Racing and their Turbo Dart. I mean, a Slant 6 is known for being incredibly reliable and incredibly unpowerful, and this is going to solve both of those problems.
Speaking of adding speed and reliability to your classic car, the Nader haters installed a Subaru WRX drivetrain in their Chevy Corvair. Now, it was super awesome, but it turns out it does make servicing the car slightly more difficult.
Malted milk balls?
But terrible Porsche 924s, and even worse than that, diesel-powered 924s.
There was a team there called the Ragin' Cajuns and Paul, and they brought a Mazda Miata that just failed tech completely on their roll cage, but there was a fabrication guy on site at MSR that was willing to help them. He was welding on the car, and then he reached a point where he needed to ask them a question, couldn't find him. Turns out they were in the rookie meeting, and depending on who your judge is for a given Lemons weekend, the rookie meeting can be rather lengthy.
How long is that meeting gonna be?
It'd be like 7 days.
Sad story, but terrible. This time the 1941 Oldsmobile. Lap one, Mary Harris is driving. I think she did like a 12,000 RPM forced double clutch downshift.
As you do.
As you do in your 41 Oldsmobile. Drive shaft broken in half. The diff yoke went with it. So it was a spectacular looking picnic table for the rest of the weekend.
Cheese balls.
Very sadly, but terrible, Tarp Racing, they've got their BMW. It started off super cheerful, as it always does, with their Hatsune Miku theme and associated sound system.
Hope springs eternal for
these
guys.
But then they just started having issues with the transmission, and by the end of the weekend, they just could not fix it. Hella Sweet was the street-going snowmobile of Tommy Salami. This thing was hella awesome.
You know what? Look, we are serious race organizers. We don't got time for that.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
There is a new addition at MSR Houston, a company called DriveTanks.com. They have a Cold War German Leopard tank. It has a 48-liter twin-turbo V12 in it.
Yeah, so that's the same engine that's in the current AMG C-Class.
Yes, that is exactly right. And for some huge amount of money, you can go there and you can drive this tank. Well, we're all too cheap to do that, but we were willing to let them run over a couple of cars. Now, let me just stress, the people's curse is not back. These were teams that were just done with their Lemons cars. Watch how long it takes for a 40-ton tank to crush a Lemons cage. pretty good, right? Now, there was this other team. They already had a Montana minivan that was given to them by Rich Tomlin of Apex Vinyl. Apex Vinyl, by the way, makes those cool numbered door kits available now at store.24hourslemons.com. Thank you for that. Now, they could not get that Montana running, but hey, not to worry. There's another free car at this track, the XNSF Sebring Lemons car. Were they able to secure that car for free?
Yes.
Did they spend all day getting that thing out of mothballs?
Someone say mothballs?
Yes.
Did they make that thing run and actually get onto the track?
Yes. Well.
I got screwed, went to Troy and Onset slash Tetanus Racing and his Datsun 240Z. He has been trying and coming pretty close to win a Lemons race. It still hasn't happened. At this time, it was really looking good. They were leading, no problems, nobody within striking distance. Three laps from the end, the lower control arm on the front suspension breaks in half. They're out of the race. They get passed up. They got screwed.
Nutella?
Heroic Fix went to Spin It to Win It in their Toyota MR2. Now, this team was, of course, signed up to do the race, but then they were also planning to do the Lemons Rally, which left on the Sunday after the Lemons race, and they were planning on doing it in their race car. One small problem, it didn't run at all on Saturday. They were trying to work this fuel problem. They were in dead last. They were working all day, all night, and they finally got it back on track on Sunday. Did they do the rally? Who knows? I left Sunday and they were still working on the car again. Maybe? The special award went to a team called The Resistance, and the award was called The Resistance is Futile. They entered three cars. Their first car was leading Class C when it hella broke and went out of the race. Their second car had suspension failure, but hey, that's okay. They know where there's a street car belonging to another team that has the same parts. They went out and they stole it off of the street car, brought it back. Surprise! Actually, not the right part. Their race car still doesn't work, but so does the other guy's street car.
Well, how'd their third car do?
Judge's choice went to the two-car team of Team Potato and Team Whiskey Throttle. Now, this is the group from Nitro Circus, which is Travis Pastrana, Lindsay Pastrana, Trevor Piranha,
Bilko Haley,
and Andy Bell, all various freestyle motocross extreme sports kind of people. Travis Pastrana, of course, known for doing tons of things in motorsports.
Yeah, one of the great things I have to say about a Lemons race is that very often you will get these known celebrity types. We've got Indy winners, we got Le Mans winners, you got all of these Nitro Circus people, and they are just coming to race, and actually, they're having a good time. They're just one of the folks. They're circulating. You could meet them, you could race against them. Now, last year, perhaps you might not have wanted to race against them.
Yeah, well, last year, the El Camino at MSR developed a reputation for kind of running into everything in sight.
Yeah.
They came back this year, and they really figured it out.
That's true.
All of those guys, they were fast, they were clean,
yep.
They were cool to everybody. I heard from multiple Lemons drivers, like, oh, man, like, Travis Pastrana, like, came over and said hi to me. And so, like, it was really a great experience, and that's how you get the judge's choice.
Snowballs?
Life of the Paddock Party Trophy went to Spin It to Win It. We talked about them before. They were the ones working on their MR2 constantly, trying to get it ready, not only to race, but also to go on the rally. They took time from working on their car to set up all of this stuff for the Saturday night party. They had a discotheque that they set up. They made a whole lot of food. And one of their people is a certified pole dancing instructor.
Certified.
I did not know there was a certification system. Apparently there is.
Yep.
And they even taught Sajeev how to do it. Organizer's choice went to the Lake Travis High School Racing Team. Not surprisingly, these were a bunch of high school kids. They had an 83 Dodge Omni Charger 2.2 that I think had been sitting in a swamp for about 25 years, and there was nothing right about it. The cage was all wrong. The cage wasn't attached to anything. They didn't have the kill switch hooked up. They didn't have seats. They didn't have seat belts. It was just terrible. In addition to which, one of the kids had recently turned 18, which means that his learner's permit, Texas driver's license, didn't work anymore, so he didn't even have a driver's license. He couldn't drive.
You know, I was talking to one of those high school kids, and he said there was some connection between the garage used on Motor Trend TV and this car was being built for a Motor Trend show.
Now that all makes sense, yeah.
Despite all of that, these kids worked incredibly hard to fix all the tech issues, fix all of the running issues, and they got out on track. And when they finally did, that Omni Charger displayed very Nissan GTR-like super handling.
Nuts. Nouns don't.
The index of effluency went to 11% racing in their Fiat X19. This is a car we've seen a couple of times over the last few years, and this is their best result yet. And this was the first time they showed up with the car dressed up completely like a C8 Corvette. Now, I will submit to you that the two best mid-engine cars of all time are the C8 Corvette and the Fiat X19.
Doc Drew. You want one?
I don't want anything to do with any of Kim's testicle-themed food.
Ding dong.
Harry's Labyrinth in a nutshell.
This is it. Stand back.
What is this? It is! It's a crayon and a snowmobile in Texas!
How's the turbo dart?
Turbo dart, do 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 do.
This is gonna be making me wake up.
I've driven past Orban, that's enough for me. Driving past Orban was awesome.
My father-in-law, he's
coming. Pass yellow, we drive down.
Okay.
That looks good on you.